मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम दिलीप उपाध्याय। गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू स्टूडेंट्स। आई हैव स्टार्टेड द यूनिट फर्स्ट ऑफ फिजिक्स फॉर क्लास 12th, हुज नेम इज इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स। इन दिस यूनिट आई स्टडी अबाउट रेस्ट चार्जेस, आर यू कैन से स्टेशनरी चार्जेस। एंड फर्स्ट लेसन ऑफ दिस टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस एंड फील्ड। स्टूडेंट्स, टूडे इट इज माई थर्ड लेक्चर। प्रीवियस फर्स्ट टू लेक्चर्स आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस एंड अबाउट न्यूट्रल एंड चार्ज्ड बॉडीज। So today I want to tell you that how can we charged a neutral body, or you can say how many processes for charging a neutral body. Now start my class as how many processes for charging a neutral body. Processes for charging a neutral body, processes for charging a neutral body. Students, I have three methods for charging a neutral body, where first is friction method, second is conduction method, and third is induction method. It means I have three methods for charging a neutral body. First is friction method, second is conduction method, and third is induction method. Now firstly we discuss about friction method. So I want to tell you about friction method. First is friction method. Students, this method mostly applicable for charging to insulators. It means charging for insulators. In this process, we rubbed two insulating bodies, and after rubbing, due to some phenomenon, due to some events, bodies will be charged. For example, we have two insulating bodies as A and B. Let us suppose that I have two insulating bodies A and B. Let us suppose that in body A there are 7 electron and 7 proton, and let us suppose that in body B there are 10 electrons and 10 protons. Since in both bodies the number of electrons and protons are equal, so both are neutral. that is body A is neutral body and body B is also a neutral body due to equal numbers of electrons and protons. Now we rub both bodies with each other. Rubbing this is rubbing. Students, in rubbing process kinetic energy converts into thermal energy. In this process kinetic energy converts into thermal energy. Due to this the electrons of outermost shell of the atom comes out in body and they transfer from one body to another body. Now we can see after rubbing let us suppose that two electrons are transferred from body A to body B. So in body A, after rubbing, in body A the number of electrons will be 5 electrons, but number of protons remains constant, so 7 protons. And in body B the number of electrons will be 12 and the number of protons will be remains constant, so 10 protons. So you can see that after rubbing the number of electrons and protons are different in both bodies, or you can say there are some difference between number of electrons and protons. Here in body A shortage of electron and here in body B excess of electron. Here two electrons are shortage in comparison to proton and here two electrons are excess in comparison to proton. So we can say the body A will be positively charged. That is, that body will be positively charged in which shortage of electron and body B will be negatively charged due to excess of electron. So on body A there will be plus 2 times because here 2 electrons are shorting. And on body B there will be minus 2 times because 2 electrons are excess. So we can say that after rubbing due to transfer of electron both bodies are charged by opposite nature. Body A will be charged by positive charge and body B will be charged by negative charge. So now I want to tell you that how can we determine the amount of charge on these bodies. Determination of amount of charge on a charged body. Amount of charge on a charged body. Students, for this calculation we have an important formula as Q बराबर यानी Q बराबर n e where n is salt is or excess of electrons and E is charge on electron whose numerical value is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb, which is known as fundamental charge. So with the help of this formula we can determine the amount of charge on a charged body. For example, the amount of charge on body E is equal to plus NE. Here N is size of electron. In body A there are two electrons are inserted, so value of N will be 2 and value of E will be 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. So finally total amount of charge on body A will be 3.2 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb, which is positive charge because in body E there are shortage of electrons. Now similarly we can determine the amount of charge on body B with the help of formula. It is negative charge, so minus N E. Here N is excess of electron, since there are two excess electrons in body B, so value of N will be 2 into E, 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. So finally total amount of charge on body B will be minus 3.2 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. So you can say that after rubbing two insulating bodies due to transfer of electron, one body will be charged by positive charge and the second body will be charged by negative charge. So and we can determine the amount of charge on the charged bodies with the help of formula NE, and this is all over concept of friction method. Now I discuss about conduction method and induction method in my fourth lecture. So stay home, be safe. So thank you.